Hey, can I have the butter?
You don't like the carrots?
I know what you want.
Oh, Mom, not at the table.
Danny, why does this embarrass you? Breastfeeding is a very natural thing.
Sure, but not for Mother.
Whose turn is it to do the dishes?
Peter's.
No way, I did them last night.
Yeah, and you did such a good job at it, I think you should do it every night.
Danny, I'll hand your brother and do the dishes.
Okay, fine, I'm going.
That white hole in the counter is a sink.
Son?
Yeah, Dad?
I realize that when it comes to doing dishes, you are up there with the best of them. Wasn't that a little fast even for you?
Well, you know, I didn't actually wash them.
Ah.
See, I was thinking, the live-in housekeeper's moving in tonight, right? And, well, hey, you know how it is. First day on a new job, not so sure what to do, feel a bit awkward. This way, boom, she's right into it.
Son, we didn't hire this woman and fly her here all the way from Australia to do your chores.
Then what do we need her for, Dad?
She's here to take care of Melissa when I go back to work. To live in my house, raise my baby, and take my place in my child's life. Oh, Ed, maybe he's right.
In the first place, Danny's almost never right.
How can I let a total stranger raise my baby? I stayed home with Danny and Peter.
Yeah, and look what good it did.
Hey, that's another thing, Dad. This lady gets my room, and I've got to live with the geek.
Hey, you're no prize. Dad, he leaves his sweat socks all over the room.
Oh, would you two knock it off?
Oh, God, it's the live-in.
Look, I'm sure she's just as nervous as we are. Now, come on, let's make her feel welcome. Welcome to America!
Thanks, Mr. Matthews.
Gator, come on in. We're waiting for the live-in.
Oh, right, you're getting one of those. Do you know the Johnsons had one? Talk about a Bowser. Never shaved their legs. All those little hairs sticking through the stockings.
Domestic agency? You are the Matthews family.
Not me.
Welcome to America.
Our home is your home.
No, you don't understand. This is your new live-in, Lisa Wells.
G'day.
Yes.
About you day and night, it's only right to think about the one you love and hold them tight, so happy together.
Toast, waffles, eggs?
Nah, just, my usual cup of Java. So, tell me, Lisa. How do you like my room?
Oh, did I take your room? I'm sorry.
No problem. Hey, I insisted that you have it.
Then those are your socks I found in the lamp.
Yeah, I knew I left those somewhere.
Well, anyway, thanks for the room. I'll just have to get used to sleeping alone.
Pardon?
I grew up in a small house. 4 beds, 8 kids. I was always fighting someone for the covers.
Well, hey, if you ever need any company, I'm right across the hall.
Beg yours?
Well, you know, if you ever get lonely.
All right. I won't get that lonely. My family promised to write me every day. But you know how kids are.
Oh, yeah. So I guess you're gonna miss them, huh?
Yes, I really am. But I'm so excited to be here.
Well, New Jersey has that effect on people.
I grew up in a sheep station in the outback. Now I am so close to New York City, I can almost taste it.
No, that's New Jersey, too. But, hey, if you ever want to see the Big Apple, maybe I could take you in and show you the sights.
Oh, that sounds great. I mean, if your mom lets me have time off.
Hey, you leave that to me, all right? We'll work something out. I mean, because after all, this whole living thing, my idea. Yeah, I call most of the shots around this house.
Danny, get your feet off the table, tape out the trash, and when the hell do you start drinking coffee?
I also do most of the heavy work.
So, Lisa, how's it going with the baby? She's not giving you any trouble, is she?
No, actually, I've hardly seen her at all. She's been with Mrs. Matthews all morning.
It's tough on her. First day back to work.
Well, I'm all ready. I've got my briefcase, my Wall Street Journal, my breast pump.
Hey, Mom, Mrs. Spiegelman's here.
Oh.
Yo-ho! Where's my commuting partner?
Come on in, Muriel.
You're in for a treat.
Oh, look at you, mother and child. It's just like a picture.
Gucci, Gucci, Gucci.
Kids, they never like me. Not even my own. He blames me for his sexual preference.
Muriel, this is Lisa Wells, our new live-in.
Oh, an au pair? Fancy schmancy. You know, the Johnsons had one of those. She robbed them blind. This one looks trustworthy.
You're adorable.
Thank you.
Keep her away from Ed.
Well, you better get going. You don't want to be late in your first morning back to work. And don't you worry. I ran that clothing department so smoothly without you, nobody even knew you were gone. Sarah, come on.
Would you like me to take Melissa now?
Now?
Now would be good.
Honey, it's time to let go now.
It's not me. Really, it's Melissa. She's not used to strangers.
Yes, Melissa, what a big smile. Yes.
My baby doesn't need me anymore.
I'll get it. So, did you boff her yet? She just moved in last night.
You get anywhere?
Gator, you gotta take your time with these things, all right? Be more subtle. Use finesse.
You struck out.
No, not at all. In fact, we practically have a date. She wants me to show her New York City.
All right! When are you going, man?
Well, you know, we haven't firmed up those details yet.
Here's your chance to get firm.
Hello.
Hi.
Lisa, getting back to this New York thing, what do you say? You, me, bright lights, big city?
Wait a minute. Did you say this is a date?
Yeah, how about it?
Oh, Danny, I don't think so.
Whiff.
I thought we'd be like mates, you know, a couple of friends hitting the town.
Yeah, right, mates.
Don't get me wrong, you seem like a very nice boy, but this is my job. In a sense, I work for you.
Well, you don't work for me. What do you say, you, me? Saturday night, wear something sexy.
If you fancy those fingers, I'd shove off. Now. Maybe Denny didn't explain this, but I'm here to take care of children, not date them.
a lot, Gator. Thank you very much. I was doing just great until you got here.
Hey, you struck out, man. At least I touched her.
All right. Well, I hope you're happy, okay? Because that one grope blew it for both of us.
Danny faced it. We didn't have a chance. The chick is obviously frigid. I think our course is clear.
It is?
Yeah, we've got to see her naked.
Yeah, I've got a bad feeling about this.
Think about it, Dano. Lisa in the shower, nude.
Okay, do it. Just watch out for the studs.
Hey, that's her problem.
Kookaburra sits in the old gum tree.
Knock it off. Here she comes.
Got it.
Oh, Melissa, you're such a good girl. Now you just sleep for 10 more minutes while I take a shower before I start dinner.
It's showtime.
Let me get that for you. Hello?
Hi, Mom.
Yes, baby's fine. Yes, Mother, she's breathing and everything. Okay, Mom, relax. So you have a staff meeting. You'll get home eventually. Okay, right, I'll tell her. Mom, I've got to go. Goodbye. She won't be home for dinner.
I didn't know you were here.
Who, me? Studying in my room. So go back to whatever you were doing in the bathroom. I mean, that's if you were there, because heck, how would I know? I'm studying in my room.
Right.
I'll get her. Let me get Melissa for you.
Now there's a mate.
See? Everything's fine. No problem. Say bye-bye.
Hold the phone, Dano. I can't see anything. What is she doing? Taking a shower in the dark?
Ooh, kinky.
Okay, hold on. There's something covering the hole.
So let's drill another one.
No, Gator. Look at us. I mean, I can't believe we would stoop this low.
You're right. I'll drill this one higher.
Gator, forget it. This was stupid anyway. Let's just go shoot some hoops before it gets dark.
All right. I'll go change. But I am very disappointed in you.
Excuse me. No peeking. What hole? That hole. I didn't see anything.
Well, I saw everything.
Hello, I'm home.
It's Dad.
I'm up here, putting the baby down.
I'm helping.
Nice to know those two are getting along.
This is all your fault. Just because I wouldn't date you, this is what you stoop to? You are so immature.
You are so conceited. I mean, do you honestly think that I care that we're not going out? Hmm? Because I've got girls lining up for me, all right? Women! Cheerleaders.
Whoa!
Hey, believe me, the last thing I need is a date with Crocodile Dundee.
Good, because you don't have one.
Good.
Fine.
Fine. Ugh.
Lisa, this is delicious.
Yeah, it's great.
It's an old family recipe.
Yeah, kangaroo stew.
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's delicious. Of course, these potatoes are a little small.
That's because they're new potatoes. They're harvested before they're mature. Immature things are usually small.
Yeah. Like, did you ever see one of those little baby carrots?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Am I missing something here?
Well, I wasn't gonna say anything, Dad, but since you brought it up, I'm not so sure this Lisa thing's gonna work out. Something about her attitude.
Yeah, she thinks you're a dweeb.
Oh, okay, like I really care what Miss Bo Peep, the sheep herder, thinks.
But Danny, did something happen between you and Lisa?
Well, Dad, it's not me. It's Melissa. I don't think she likes Lisa. I mean, she threw strained peas at her dad.
And
I think the evidence speaks for itself. Now, I realize this is a bit inconvenient, but hey, I think we might just have to let her go.
What the hell are you doing?
Signaling the help to clear.
Someone wants something?
Yes, Danny wanted to let you know that he'd be doing the dishes tonight.
Why, thank you, Danny. He's such a nice boy.
This is a dog. Okay. Turkey.
Yep, it works.
I left a plate for Mrs. Matthews in the oven. Can I get you anything? Coffee, juice, warm milk?
No, thank you.
Good night, Ben.
Lisa, is everything okay?
Fine, why?
You getting along with the kids?
Oh, Melissa's a doll, and Peter's really quite good on the clarinet, isn't he?
And Danny?
I don't think he plays the clarinet. Good night, Mr. Matthews.
I'm home. I made it. Oh. Is Melissa okay?
She's asleep. She's fine. Everything, everybody is fine.
What's wrong?
It's nothing. It's absolutely nothing. And I'm sure it'll go away.
Edward?
All right, something might have happened between Lisa and Danny.
Like what?
Sweetheart, think about it. He's a healthy boy. And she's a cute, young, healthy... Well, you've seen her. I'd say that Danny, in his inimitable way, probably encouraged, you know, by Gator.
He hit on her.
I'd be worried about him if he didn't.
And she turned him down.
From the ice between them at dinner, I'd say it was quick and merciless.
Aw. How's he taking it?
Like any normal male handles rejection.
Oh, he's acting like a child.
Exactly. So, how was your first day back at work?
Oh, Ed. It was awful. I have to fire Muriel Spiegelman. Oh, Ed, what am I going to do?
Well, it's never easy to give somebody bad news, but you're just going to have to sit her down and tell her.
You're right. I have no choice. Tomorrow, at the end of the day, I'll fire her.
Oh, Melissa, I'm gonna miss you. If you ever get down under, give a call.
Honey, we're home.
You.
Me?
What did you say to your father about me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't you remember? Last night at dinner, you said we should fire her.
Thank you, Pete.
Well, you'll be glad to know you got your wish.
What?
Last night I heard them talking. When your mum gets home from work, I'm getting the boot. What?
Didn't you say anything?
Look, it's clear you don't want me here because of what happened between us.
Something happened between you?
And if you're not mature enough to get past this, there's nothing I can do about it.
Get past what?
And it's all so silly. I have four brothers. It's not like I haven't seen a boy naked.
She saw you naked?
I didn't mean that stuff I told Dad.
When did she see you naked?
I can't believe he listened to me. I mean, Dad never listens to me. Why would he start now?
Did you see her naked?
Oh, what a day. Don't ever go into sporting goods. The pressure.
Dad, we gotta talk. You know that stuff I said last night about Lisa and how she wasn't working out? Well, Melissa threw strained peas at her. Well, maybe it's not Lisa she doesn't like, but peas. I mean, Dad, let's face it, no one likes peas, especially all mushed up in a jar like that.
What's your point, son?
Yeah, Dan, what's your point?
It's just, I kind of like Lisa. I mean, she's a good person, and she needs this job, and I don't think you should fire her.
Fire Lisa? Why would I do that?
Well, I thought because of the things I said.
Son, I never listen to you. Why would I start now?
Muriel, I'm sorry I had to let you go. I had no choice. I'm really, really, really...
Enough already!
Sarah, you are a big executive now. Part of your job is to fire people. I understand, honey.
Muriel, you're such a good person.
Yeah, then why'd you fire me?
I'm kidding. Take care of her. I'll see you Sunday at Lita's brunch.
You fired her? You fired Mrs. Spiegelman?
Yes, I did.
Well, this really burns my butt. What do you want?
To apologize. I guess I was a little confused about this firing thing.
I guess so.
But I would like to say thanks for sticking up for me. It really means a lot to know you like me.
Let's get one thing straight, okay? I do not like you.
No, yes, you do.
Oh, no, I don't.
You told your dad you did. At least that's what Peter said.
Excuse me, I have to go. Save my life.
Look, I understand. You're still angry and humiliated. And it's not really fair, is it? I mean, I did see you naked. And there's nothing we can do about that. The only way to make it even would be if you saw me naked.
Well, yeah, I guess you're right.
Too bad, because you never will.
Can a brainy man be as attractive as a brawny man? Find out when Murphy Brown dates the world's smartest scientist later tonight. Now stay tuned for the premiere of a down-home comedy series. Country Living was never as funny as it is on Heartland. Next.